What's up Kelly fam, it's Jannik here. So do you want to know how to get on top of the bar, but are you not able to do a muscle up? Then keep watching this video because I'm gonna explain how to do a pullover. Guys, so the pullover is basically one of the easiest ways to get on top of a high bar, but you just gotta know how to do the technique of this exercise. So that's exactly what I'm gonna explain in this tutorial video. So first of all, why do you want to get on top of a high bar? So when you cannot do a muscle up, it is a very good way to get on top of the bar to, for example, practice the negative muscle up. And besides the negative muscle up, there are also other exercises such as the straight bar dip, because on a lot of calisthenics parks, they don't have like low bars, just like this one or like that one. They only have high bars, so it's an easy way to get on top of the bar to perform straight bar dips. And the last reason is actually because it's a very good compound exercise, because you work the core and your back muscles with one exercise. So first I'm gonna explain how to do the technique of this exercise. I'm gonna take you through several progressions, and then I'm gonna explain some of the exercise that benefits this move. So first of all, we're gonna start with a low bar. So this is an easy variation because you don't have to pull yourself up. So I'm gonna use this bar right here. So why is the lower bar easier than the higher bar? It's basically because you don't have to pull yourself up, because you're already beginning with a bent arm. And with a high bar, you're beginning with straight arms. So you have to pull yourself up and then get your hips over the bar. So with this bar, that's not necessary. What you wanna do is with both variations, so low bar and high bar, you wanna use a swing. So you wanna have 1 foot under the bar. You can use the other leg to swing. So you're gonna have 1, 2, like that. And then you can keep rolling backwards. But first I'm gonna show you guys a little trick that you can use. In a lot of videos about this exercise, they're always referring to getting your hips to the bar, and then it's just gonna happen. But what you actually need to do is tuck your knees in. I'm missing this tip on a lot of videos because what's gonna happen when you only gonna have your hips towards the bar, you're basically gonna hang like this. And now what's next, you know? So I cannot go over the bar. And I also, seriously, I do a lot of group training, and when we do this exercise for negative muscle-ups, for example, we see a lot of people hanging in this position and then fluttering around with their legs, and then, oh, I'm gonna get over the bar. So
they get really scared.
Yeah, they get really scared. They're gonna ask for help to get back to the ground again. So what you wanna do is you wanna tuck your knees in as fast as possible. So that's basically the trick that you wanna apply. So 1, 2, tuck the knees. So now I'm already far more over the bar. The only thing that I have to do is get my head towards the ceiling. So that's actually another tricky point. So when you have your tucked knees over the bar, you wanna have one, you wanna create momentum to get back over the bar. And what you wanna focus on is getting your head towards the ceiling or towards the air, and your feet towards the floor. So like this. So you hang like this. And now you want to kick your legs towards the floor, like this. And then your head towards the ceiling. So 1, 2, and see, it's basically very easy if you do the timing very well. So that's basically the technique on a low bar. And this is pretty easy because you can, you don't have to do like the pull-up part. So now let's move on to the high bar. Now what you want to do is, meanwhile you're doing the swing, you want to do a little pull. So pull, tuck knees, and then do a little trick that I explained at the previous exercise. So one more time. Once you're getting the swing, you want to do the pull at the same time. So one, two, get up, pull, tuck knees, and rotate. So I'm actually not noticing that I'm pulling because I'm just focusing on getting my hips towards the bar and flipping my knees over. So there's one other way when you have a little bit of a difficulty with doing the pull. What you also can do, it's a little bit harder, but you can also first do the pull and then with the strength of your core, flip over the bar. So that would look like this. So you're gonna hang, first do pull, and then get over the bar. So then you're gonna actually do the same movement on this one, but then from a hanging position. So one more time, hang, pull, knees over the bar. So these were the points on the technique of the pullover. So now I'm gonna explain some of the exercises that can help you to build strength to unlock this exercise. So one of the most important exercises to unlock the pullover is toes to bar. The toes to bar is actually a movement that really looks like the pullover, because what you want to do is you want to bring your toes towards the bar like this instead of your hips. So the pullover is actually a combination between the toes to bar and a pull-up. So the toes to bar like this. If you can perform this exercise for only 6 repetitions, then you already got the strength to unlock the pullover. So I would recommend to have this exercise in your workout routine and do like 3 to 4 sets of 6 repetitions. So another exercise that you can do to make the pullover easier is the regular pull-up, because I just showed you that you need a little bit a pull strength to get over the bar. So it's basically just doing pull-ups like this. So if you can do also 6 to 8 pull-ups, you definitely have enough strength in your back to do the pullover. So the toes to bars and the pull-up, if you have mastered these two exercises, you can definitely do the pullover. Alright guys, so now you know exactly how to unlock the pullover. So once you have the pullover, you can make this exercise a little bit harder to do several variations. First of all, you can do repetitions, so several repetitions with a swing. That would look like this. 1, 2. And one of the harder variations is to do this exercise from a dead hang position, so using no swing at all. So you're gonna hang with your feet completely straight like this, and now you're gonna do the pullover. If you wanna make it really hard, you can do multiple repetitions. Up to you. It's a good challenge also to challenge friends when you're at a workout park and you want to get on top of a high bar without doing a muscle up. You can challenge your friends. So if you like these kind of videos, like explaining one skill in a short video, like talking about the technique but also exercise that can help you to unlock the skill, please let us know in the comments which skill you like to see us covering in one of the videos. This was actually an idea of one of the previous videos. Someone commented that they want to learn the pullover, and we're also thinking about doing the skin the cat, and we have some other skills on our to-do list for the video. So we really listen to you guys in the comments, so let us know. Thanks for watching, and I hope that this video was helpful, and if you liked the video, please put your thumbs up and also subscribe if you haven't yet. And if you want to learn more skills like this, the pullover, or maybe if you want to learn the muscle up to get on top of the bar with another exercise, then check out our website and sign up for one of our programs. So that's it for today, and I see you guys next week. Peace out.
When I found Calisthenics Family, and they were offering this program plus the online coaching for a very affordable price. So I decided to try it. If anyone's looking to start calisthenics, I would highly recommend this. It'll do the same for you.
I'm Gordon, and I've been with Calisthenics Family for almost 3 months now, and all the time I've had Yannick as my trainer.
Like Mike or Yannick can just be like that little extra push to keep you going. You also seen the pictures. I'm really proud of myself that what I achieved in the last 8 weeks.
Go for it and start your journey.